Spider-Man as well. I love the comic. The comic was pretty cool, but obviously they can't quite do everything they did in the comic book. So I'm interested to see how they adapted it for the comics, or for the movie, I should say. All right, really gotta get the eyes down. If I don't get the eyes right, everything looks off, especially when you're doing faces. Looks like, yeah, pivot this just a little bit. Okay, that looks a little better. There's my sketch. Everything looks good. Let's pull out the watercolors. Everything sounds so loud. Just water. And you kind of see what happened already there. I forgot to erase it a little bit and got some lead, but that's fine. We'll figure it out. We'll get it nice and wet and everything will work out. Okay. Let's see here. Alright, it's about 10:30 here. Like I said, this is going to be a quick sketch, so let's see. Let's just time this and see how long this takes. I think I probably need some oranges in the background to kind of match what's happening here and the Captain America piece next to it. So that. Let's fade that into a little green. Let's darken it up by her face a little bit. So one of the things when you have little portraits and whatnot, sometimes I try to darken the area, haloing the face a little bit. And even though this is green and her hair is red, that's fine. It'll add some contrast and it'll help pull out the face a bit more near the end, right? So I want the body to pop, so that means pushing initially back with some darker colors. In this case, it's going to be some cool colors because I want her face, and her hair is very red and warm with that. How long does it take to do one of these? These I'm trying to do pretty quickly. The Iron Man and Captain America ones kind of, these are really quick and rough, probably took about an hour, so that's what I'm giving myself for these. Recently did some life drawing, we had a model and everything else, and went through a series of poses, and it was actually kind of fun to have something kind of timed. to just act, because sometimes even I get lost in just what am I going to do, how am I going to approach this, and just kind of stagnate. So I think these warm-ups that I've been doing, that where I'm not limiting myself by time, but more so just being aware of how long it's taking me, I think has been useful. So one of the things I'm actually going to do, I'm actually going to color her hair initially yellow, even though I know her hair is going to be red. And the reason why I'm doing that is that the highlights, I can go over the yellow with some red later and it'll be an orange, but I do want some yellow highlights to come through. And so I'll start that process by giving it a base coat of yellow. So I'm thinking a couple steps ahead to try and identify what my highlights are going to be later on in the future. And same thing with her skin. I'm gonna add a little bit of yellow in certain areas where I want the light source to be coming in and where I want the highlights to be. I'm actually gonna have the highlights over here to the top right to balance off the Iron Man I did a few days ago. And so I'm gonna actually experiment a bit with that. We'll see if it works or not. And this is where I might spend too long looking up references and find the perfect picture, lighting sources and all that, which I've done in the past and it is very helpful to do, and I suggest everyone do it. But sometimes you just have to literally experiment and try and do things. Alright, I'm going to add some. Again, I am not worried too much. I'm just trying to cover up white space and identify areas that I want to preserve. Want this side of the face to be a slight blue, so I'm trying to dilute a blue right now and just find a warm blue. And to find a warm blue, it's finding a blue that's closer to the spectrum of green, because blue with oranges, blue with reds and stuff like that will tend to be a little green, but I want it to stay slightly blue because I feel like it. Get a clean brush right now, get some clean water and just moisten these edges. I don't want anything really, I don't want any harsh edges right now, especially on her face and especially being female. So yes, you kind of make things a little softer for the females. Because those are the stereotypical characteristics, and you pull that into art. All right. adjusted my lighting for the cameras, but then I'm getting this shine and glare off. Off the water that's on my paper right now, so it's a little awkward. Does that look okay? So on the other side of her face, I want it to be really warm. And so I'm gonna add some reds and yellows. I'm trying to find myself a flesh tone. And again, keeping it very light in the beginning. Letting it all blend and become very soft. I'm going to use some of that same color and put that in her hair, just to kind of unify some things. Put some under her chin. And again, so what was a little bit harsher with the greens and blues that I had in the shadows of her faces are starting to get diluted and washed out. So yeah, I gotta rethink these lights. Reverend, I noticed that it was a delay. I haven't figured out how to change that delay. I'm using OBS Studio. If anyone has any suggestions on where to do and where to go on that, more than happy to figure that out. Sure. How did that happen? I didn't even know there was a slow mode. I know there is a dark mode. Yay! Hooray for things I don't know how to do. All right. The other nice little tip I learned about many, many... I forget where, when, or how, was that... and I'll do it in this stage, and while I'm talking I should keep it moist. Is that there are three general bands of color in a human face, and it varies depends on skin tones and a variety of other things, but there's a band of red that typically sits around the cheeks, the eyes, and the nose. Why? Because that's where a lot of the vasculature and blood vessels and where you blush and everything else like that, more pronounced and light toned, light fair-skinned, but it's there even in, even if you have darker skin or tans and stuff like that. So what I do is often take a very light pink, and while things are wet, and I'll just hit these areas. In this case, there's a little crimson here, and I'll put it around the nose, and I'll try to really under the eyes, around the nose. I'll add this sort of band of pinks and reds. Regardless, it's generally a little warmer. So if you have like an African American skin tone, it might end up being a little more orange in that area. In the forehead is generally a band of sort of yellows. And so the yellows, it's just because you have thin skin here and the bone and stuff like that, and you don't have too much, too many blood vessels up there that, you know, so it gets a little more yellow. And actually down in the chin area, it's a little more, you see a little more blues, and that can be caused because of shadows in men, and some women, I guess, just presence of hair follicles and stuff like that. So I will generally, unless I have references that tell me otherwise, harsh light sources can change all that. But on a whim, that's what I'll try to do. Slightly more blues down here in the chin. Just under the lip for shadows. I'll add some of the same blue under the eyes here. But then it's starting to come together. Your power is amazing. I am awed and bow to your fortitude. One day I will figure all this stuff out. All right, and so let's add some brighter yellows up here. This is going to be my light source, so I'm going to let that bleed into her hair. Some really vivid yellows. Let's really hit it. And we'll let that drip as well. And we'll touch it with a little bit of orange. We'll let that drop. Get some sienna at the bottom to darken that up. Blend that in there. Move that into this. Captain America piece. So not only does your little paper towel pick up water to help minimize mistakes, but you can also add a little texture with that too. Okay, I'm gonna let this dry just a touch before I begin, and here's where I will take a quick little Instagram photo. And drink some milk. So how you doing, Reverend? Still on here? We'll just do a quick tag. I switched my keyboard on my phone to this Google keyboard. I'm not used to where everything is. I think I might have to switch it back. This is taking me far longer than I expected. Let's pop that on. All right, let's see what happens. The tough part about getting watercolors not muddy is to make sure things dry before you start putting on other colors. The thing with it, and also being aware of some of the colors that you're using, because watercolor is transparent, you'll get, if you layer too many complementary colors together, they'll shift and they will get brown and muddy. So for the hair and for these areas, I'm primarily using warm colors with the yellows and stuff like that. And I'll come back in with the reds, but I'm not gonna add the blues or try to let anything blend in accidentally, because then you'll get the browns and stuff like that. Some of the blues that I already used in this area by her collar has sort of muddied out, but I can punch that up. So this is where starting very light with very watered down washes is going to allow you the latitude later on to go in harsher with a color and really pull that out. So later on, I'll probably end up putting in some dark purples and navies in here, and you'll get the blue back from this muddied area over here. But it does happen, and just start slow. Okay, this looks pretty decent. I'm gonna put it on mute for a quick second while I pull out the handy dandy hair dryer. Hopefully I did have that on mute. Otherwise it got really loud. The question was, do you stretch your paper first? Depends on if I'm using loose paper or if I'm not. This Arches Aquarelle watercolor blocks they're sealed all around, so it holds the paper flat. This is a piece I'll be doing a little later, but it'll hold the piece flat for you so you don't have to worry about stretching, and it's kind of already pre-stretched in that sort of weird term, as it can be. But I do have larger pieces where I have to mount to a board and things like that. Maybe I'll pull one out later to work on. But that stuff definitely needs to be stretched a little bit. On Facebook. Pop up there. Let's see what's happening. All right. Let's add some oranges and reds to her hair. And let's start making her more scarlety. Alright, so lights come in here, and so we'll add some of the warmer oranges. Using the other end of my brush to kind of pull out the pools of water to kind of get the wisps of hair, so to speak. I could use a small brush and do the exact same thing, but you can actually, since I'm lazy and I don't want to keep going back and forth, you can do it that way. And I'm just gonna, I'm grabbing this old rusty color at the that's been in my palette for who knows how long. I'm just gonna use that to kind of dab in this moist area around the edge of her face, and then let the water and physics just kind of pull that to the side. All right. With the darkest area probably by her eyes. Painting's a lot about getting the contrast right and what areas you want to pull forward and drop back. And so in the case of watercolor, we'll let the water create our nice gradients for us while it's wet. And if we want to go details, this is where you start working much drier, where you make sure the paper is dry and you use less and less water. So I will use less and less water as I move forward. All right, and so here on this side, I'm using more the shadow that I did on the other side here. I'm gonna use that as sort of the base on this side. Okay. I wonder how loud that sounds. Just tapping my brush to get rid of some extra water. And again, while I still have that color mixed, I am going to use it around her. Around her eyes, around her nose, and around her lips. Right. I'm just going to kind of get this area. Get another clean brush. Use some clean water and dab along the edges of her eyes here with clean water, and that'll pull away, fade out, if you will, some of that red. But I'll leave that for her lips and nose. I do want a harder edge. Okay. Again, to kind of go for the edges and things like that. Whoops. I want to define that edge of the hair, so I think I'm going to go in with a little green in that background. And I'll make sure to make it a slightly cooler green, because her hair is going to be yellow and warm. So I want to make sure that my green that's in the background is cool. So not only do I have a contrast in color, I have a contrast in temperature, and I'll have a contrast in saturation. Maybe I'll use a little bit of that green along the edge of her face here too, and in these really bigger shadow areas. And I'll pop some of that in her eyes. I think her eyes are green. If not, they are now. Her nostrils with it, the corners of her lips with it. And let's get a little bit under her chin. Again, just finding ways to bring some of this color and dab it in. to me, that's how I try to unify and I'll hint at her chest here by getting some contrast. Darker in this lower area because I want the brighter area to be up there, and so let's do some very general loose washes. And again, as long as I hint at these forms, I'm not going to spend too much time down here. This is a quick kind of watercolor sketch, but keeping it much more loose here, and then in a few moments I'll spend a lot more time around her face area and get the details in there. And that will help the picture focus as well. So some clean paper towels here. Again, using the edge of my flat brush to help provide some straight lines so I don't have to be so precise with them later on. Right, because it's really hard to get straight lines sometimes, but a wide flat brush will help you get some of those lines. And I do want to get some of that for her costume down here, and I'll just hit that and see what happens. Again, I don't know exactly what's going to happen in this lower area. It's very wet right now. A lot of colors are running into each other. Some areas are drier. Right. So I'm trying to hint that warmer colors on the right and cooler colors on the left of this arm. Cooler colors also include purples. All right. Started this around 10:30. It's about halfway through right now. I'm going to give myself another 20 minutes to finish this up. I'll put you on mute for a second. Thank you. All right. Bye. You're awesome, Ash. So I think as I was saying, after the hair dryer, I have to make a note to myself. Moving on to smaller brushes, getting into the details, your larger brushes are now over and done with. And I'm just gonna focus the next 20 minutes or so on her face. Get some of the shadow in here. We'll see how this works out. This might be a little bit too dark, but I am hoping that I'm going under the premise and knowledge that watercolor dries lighter than when it is on right now. And I want there to be some sort of contrast here where the shadows are. And on the side of her nose, soften that area up. Soften this line up. So this is just clean water, just to soften the shadows. And definitely have to bring those shadows at least as dark down to this neck area, because that neck area is going to have to be even darker. Color are her eyes. Thank you, Shay. Thank you. Looks like they're green. So let's add some green. We will add in the pupils at the end. The darkest darks and the lightest lights for me happen at the very end after I get the colors in. Let's see here. Let's mix a good color for her here. With smaller brushes, you get less water, and the other thing is you will be able to get better lines of colors here. Areas of color, areas of saturation, I guess. start getting her eyebrows in. Hint at those colors there. Hint at the red around her nose. At the bridge and base of her nose. And her lips. Now, the thing with the lips, generally speaking, the upper lip is actually darker, mostly because the light sources are coming from above. So the upper lip is generally a darker color. You can think of it as darker color, you can think of it as less saturation than the bottom lip. The bottom lip is the one that has all the gloss and the lighting and lighting effects, the shiny lips and all that stuff that happen. Let's put some, just adding a little bit of a, so with thin brushes, what you can do is literally just drop color on one edge of it, and the bottom part of the top lip is even darker. And so that'll help create that separation that we have there, as well as the bottom part of the bottom lip to kind of show that that's sticking out. Right? And let's pull some browns and red together, and let's hit a little bit of this air. And that'll blend into some of the cheek here. And let's use some of that brown. I think it's an umber. For her eyebrows. Now again, I really don't know my colors very well. I have a lot of colors here. I know a few of them, but I don't have their names memorized. I don't have a particular combination that I use every single time for eyebrows or for red hair. So much of that changes and depends on the lighting that you're choosing, the other elements in the piece. There is a lot that can affect the color that you use. So every piece, I'm figuring out the same sort of problems again. I have a few colors that I do enjoy using from time to time, but not in any consistent sort of way. All right, starting to come together. All right. And so I'll come back in and darken the eyes, but definitely here with the blue cool area. I was at a acrylic, so someone on the chat says that she has a pair of boots that need some color. I was at a acrylics workshop and I accidentally dropped a tube of soft acrylic paints, which really is very liquidy, and it splattered all over this girl's boots. And I felt horrible. So, apparently, she's letting me have it. It just seems right. Who doesn't want a pair of teal boots? I think everyone wants a pair of teal boots. have a pair of teal boots. What are you even putting on your feet? Oh, I am never living down the fact that I splattered teal paint all over your boots. I shudder at the fact in what you will get me for Christmas now. Okay. Just trying to reshape her face a little bit. Looks like I have about 10 minutes or so. I'm gonna try to so looks like this piece is gonna take longer than expected. Looks like there's going to be a lot more. I'm going to have to put a little bit more effort into this as we didn't proceed as fast as I would like on this. But there is a lot that I do and think turned out pretty well. So maybe I'll come back to this one another day. I do want to work on a few other pieces. Alright. Yeah, because I'm going to have to wait for the area under her nose to dry to get the nostrils in there. That's not letting that dry enough. And also get some of this lighting that I really want to hit harder. Let's just darken up some of the leather and neck just to really pull that stuff out. And we'll call this done for the day. Not bad for about an hour's worth. Still haven't quite hit the edges yet, hit the full contrast on this, but not bad. Took some chances, took some risk on things. I think it turned out okay. What do you guys think? Looking okay? You just need my boot size. Blue Suede Shoes was only an Elvis Presley song. Actually, let me at least get a little bit of the eyes in here. Otherwise, it'll look weird. You'll have to ask about my boot size later. I don't know yet if I'm going to give you that much ammo on me. Come back to this one later. We'll work on a few other things. That could be cool.